Though President Donald Trump seems remarkably enthused about the prospect of being interviewed under oath by special counsel Robert Mueller, many conservatives strongly believe he should tread with caution and perhaps even consider opting out of the interview altogether. The reason for this trepidation lies with the risk the president faces of being ensnared in a perjury trap, or what CBS News describes as a situation in which his story does not match the evidence. But the concern isn't that Trump will lie during the interview, but rather that he'll accidentally portray the facts in a way that could be construed legally as a lie. To get a broad idea of what I mean, take a look at this meme by pro-Trump cartoonist Ben Garrison. While the meme is in itself an exaggeration, it cleverly underlines the concept of a perjury trap. Look at it like this: suppose you're having a horrible day, but I suddenly exclaim to you, "Good morning." Because your morning isn't actually good, you could conceivably accuse me of lying. For an even better example, think about all the fact checks the leftist media constantly run on Trump's statements. As noted by the Daily Wire last year, leftist fact-checkers often use assumptions, peculiar rationales, and misdirections to accuse Trump of lying, when in reality, he told the truth. For instance, the New York Times recently published a fact-check piece titled, 10 Falsehoods from Trump's Interview with the Times. Yet according to an analysis by Breitbart, only two of the president's statements were actually false, and they were two relatively minor issues that could well have been the work of a faulty memory. The rest were either largely true or just statements of opinion with which the Times happened to disagree, explained Breitbart senior editor-at-large, Joel Pollack. Just imagine what would happen if Mueller were to be as sickeningly biased during his proceedings with Trump. See the problem now? This is why conservatives such as columnist Pat Buchanan are adamant that Trump should not sit for an interview with Mueller. He should not sit for any extended interview by FBI agents whose questions will be crafted by prosecutors to steer our disputatious president into challenging or contradicting the sworn testimony of other witnesses, Buchanan opined in a recent op-ed for Tannell. So what should Trump do instead? Let the special counsel submit his questions in writing, and let Trump submit his answers in writing, Buchanan argued. Here's the problem: last week the president told reporters he was looking forward to sitting with Mueller, as reported by CNN. Let's just hope somebody explains to him before it's too late why this could well be a very bad idea. From the start of his campaign for the presidency, Trump has made it very clear he does things his way. This might be one time to listen to some advice. Please share this story on Facebook and Twitter, and let us know what you think about the concerns conservatives such as Pat Buchanan have about the president sitting for an interview with Mueller.